Welcome back to Milwaukee Beer Review and the Advent Calendar Series. As always, I'm Josh.
And I'm Ross.
And we have our wonderful special guest, Tyler, from Kenosha, here with us tonight, rolling on day 19. It is day 19. It is the Monday before Christmas, the last Monday before Christmas, and it is Monday night football night. And I believe the Green Bay Packers have a 6% chance to make the playoffs, but we are going to roll with them tonight too. So let's dive into this box and see what we got. As a reminder, Tyler knows what we're drinking. Ross knows what we're drinking. I have no idea. It seems like a tall can in here. And I can't. There we go. This is a good Monday night football beer. So this is the Driftwood Porter from Raised Grain. Can't see that with my lighting, but Ross's is better. Interestingly, this is actually aged in bullet bourbon barrels. So I actually like bullet bourbon. It's pretty decent. So this is a hefty one for a Monday night. What do we got for an ABV on here? Do they say?
I looked that up beforehand, and funny enough, this comes in at 6.7%. The regular Driftwood comes in at 6.7%.
That can't be right.
That's every site that I went to look at. I thought the same thing. I checked three sites. It all said the same thing.
So, yeah, I was really excited. I grabbed it. I'm like, oh, I'm going to look at the ABV because I couldn't find it on the can. Same thing. I was like, oh, 6.7 is pretty low for being in a barrel.
Yeah.
I think technically, though, like you're not supposed to report any alcohol you pick up in the barrel. So it's probably more than 6.7, but.
Right. I guess it depends on how long they age it in the barrel and stuff too, right? Because you're gonna brew a thicker, maltier beer to really kind of, you know, sit in that barrel and age out for a year plus. Maybe this is short-lived in the barrel. Who knows?
Yeah.
So the description says a deliciously smooth porter intertwined with Madagascar vanilla and chocolatey dark roasted malts aged in bullet bourbon barrels. So let's crack this thing open. It is a porter. I'm guessing it's going to be on the dark brown side, which it is. Not quite jet black like a stout.
Got that nice tan head.
Yeah, lots of carbonation coming out the can. Looks like a tasty porter. I'm getting wafts of a little vanilla, I think, in the air. A little bourbon, maybe?
Yeah.
To the nose we go. Let's sniff it. Yeah, it smells like bullet bourbon.
Yeah, there's a oakiness to it as well. But yeah, mm-hmm. that bullet shows up pretty quickly, even it's like a foot from my face, you know?
Yeah, it's a very fresh bourbon note. Makes me wonder if my hypothesis is correct that this was not in barrels for very long. Smells good, though. A little bit of vanilla, a little bit of the chocolatey note there. I'm not getting a lot of the like smoky characters, but I'm getting a little bit of the barrel, I think, like Tyler said. Don't drink a lot of barrel-aged porters, so this will be a treat.
Yeah, I was just thinking to myself, trying to think of ones I've had in the past, and they're few and far between, so.
Yeah. Any other thoughts before we take it down the hatch, boys?
I'm just curious what the level of roastiness, like you said, is. I'm picking up like a little bit of like oak tannin, so I'm just hoping that calms down once we taste it, you know. So
anyway. Let's find out.
Yeah.
Cheers, boys.
Cheers.
Ooh. Now, I don't know if that's bullet bourbon. If it's the bourbon, it's got to be. But I'm definitely getting like an apple character on the very front. I don't know if that's the bourbon. I can't recall if bullet puts out kind of a little bit of an apple fruity note along with it. That can sometimes be a bad sign in beer too.
I think kind of like I mentioned right before we tried it, I think that like fresh oak, when you don't give it time to mellow out, also can kind of provide that flavor as well. So I'm almost wondering if it's more oak tannin that gives you that apple. I definitely get the apple as well, but I don't know if it's necessarily like an oxidation issue. I think it's more of maybe just that fresh oak that hasn't had time to mature fully is my, I don't know. That's my guess. I don't know.
That's fair. I mean, I'm getting the same thing. I mean, I will say this, when you get rid of that kind of that apple tinge to it, there is a good spirit flavor on this one.
Mm-hmm.
It lacks some of the smokiness I really want to have a porter. And if you can get, if some beer can figure out how to make a really good smoky porter that's aged in some sort of bourbon barrel, I think we'd really hit it out of the park, because that would be such a good combination. This has the spirit flavor down though. It's got a little bit of chocolatiness, a little bit of kind of fudginess to it. Being a porter, it's going to be slightly thinner than your stouts and everything on the mouthfeel, all that, a little more carbonized. Or, yeah, you get what I'm saying.
Carbonated?
There is the word. I mean, overall, I mean, I do like the bit of the spirit flavor that you get in there, that apple-ish tinge. I think I'm a little scarred by that, because I never know what it is exactly, if it's, as Tyler said, an oxidation issue, if it's supposed to be there, or now as I'm learning, it could be part of the oak that they're picking up. But I do like kind of like, I think what it's supposed to be coming up, that initial taste that comes off of it.
I know that Elijah Clark bourbon tends to have kind of a bit of an apple tinge to it, and I get that in beers that are aged with Elijah Clark. I can't recall a beer I've had aged in bullet bourbon barrels, though. So I'm not sure. It's probably closer to what Tyler's saying. What's interesting about this is that, like, for me, you get that, like, that bright apple character right on the front, but the porter's just not quite strong enough to pick up the back end. It's just a little thin. It's missing some of those traditional porter characteristics. If you let it linger on the palate for a while, they start to come through. I think as you kind of let it sit on the palate, I get a little bit more dark malt and a little bit of roastiness behind it, but it's like pretty faint. I think this beer needed to be bigger to support the barrel aging that's being done to it, personally.
I was just going to bring that up. I think that's a factor when you're putting something in a barrel, is you need to have enough malt presence and backbone and character just to fight past some of that intensity. So I think you're right on in the fact that if this was a 10, 11%, we probably wouldn't be talking about that apple presence as much, you know?
Mm-hmm. The thing is it tastes good.
Yeah.
It's just a little thin. It's light, which is a weird combination for a beer that's bourbon barrel aged. Like, you just expect a certain viscosity, a certain character to that beer, and it's just not there with this. It's just very thin, and everything feels subdued, buried.
It's funny what you guys are saying, because as I was trying to find the ABV on this and make sure I was right, I read a review real quick on Beer Advocate, just see what they said. And they had this long description, but the bottom of it was, the only thing you think as I kept reading this is, what if? It's basically, what if they would have just done this or that? Like, it's just missing that one little thing to really kind of put over the top.
And yeah,
everything you guys are saying is exactly what I read in that review. So it's so funny how spot on that is, and what that kind of overall feeling is among people who drank this.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I think I can understand, though, like, what they were trying to attempt, because you're taking all that awesome, like, character that you get from a barrel age stout or porter, and you're kind of making it more sessionable, right? Like, mm-hmm. instead of having one and being completely trashed, depending on who you are, it's like, hey, I can sit down, enjoy a pint by myself, and not feel like crap the next day. That's probably their attempt, is, you know, but
that's fair.
I think I go one direction or the other. Either make it taste sessionable. Like, I think Rocky's Revenge from Tyrannia is a really good job, because that's technically a bourbon barrel brown. And it's not a high ABV. It's not high ABV, but it doesn't have like a strong spirit taste to it, where this has a strong spirit taste to it, but it lacks kind of that punch behind it. So I think you just kind of go one direction or the other. Don't kind of go in between and try to do both. It just misses the mark.
Yeah.
It is good, though. I think you guys, like, I don't disagree that it's a good beer, though.
End of the day, I would drink this. I show up at someone's house and they hand me this. Hey, I'll definitely drink this. It's a good tasting beer. I would enjoy it casually. But I think like I said, it's just missing something. If I'm going untapped on this, I'm probably going a 3. I just think it's kind of meh. It's not undrinkable. Like I said, I would drink it, but I think a 3 is a fair score for this. It's just not anything special.
I'll go 3.25. For no difference of what you just said, I just enjoy it a little bit more. So I'll go 3.25.
Yeah, I was thinking 3.25 as well. I think I like the attempt of the idea behind it. Overall, the spirit character is there. I think if you stripped away that apple character, it would be probably a 3.5, 3.75. That apple's a little hard to like overcome as you're kind of halfway through your pint and you're like, it's just not going away. So I'll go 3.25.
All righty. Well, hey, not a bad beer. First one in the box from Raised Grain. Fun to see something in there from them. some of our local brewing heroes out of Waukesha. So good stuff and kind of fun to try this one because it's one I haven't had from them in the past. So, all right, day 19 in the books, gentlemen. We've got football to watch. We're going to kick it back and we're going to be back here tomorrow night for day 20, getting ever so much closer to Christmas Eve and the finale to this wonderful Advent calendar series. So, Tyler, thanks for joining, and we'll see all of you tomorrow after the Packers win.
All right. Thanks, everyone.
Bye-bye.